Hachette Audio presents 90% Mental. An all-star player turned mental skills coach reveals the hidden game of baseball. Written by Bob Tewksbury and Scott Miller. Read by Bob Tewksbury. To the three people who make my world complete, my son, Griffin, and daughter, Jenna, who give me joy, happiness, and endless love, I'm so very proud of both of you and the best teammate a man could ever have, my amazing wife, Laura, who has been a continued source of strength and love for over 30 years. Here's to 30 more. I love you. Bob Tewksbury. For my wife, Kim, and daughter, Gretchen, who keep me going. For my parents, Alan and Rosemary, who got me going. Scott Miller. Prologue, Scottsdale, Arizona, March 1st, 2017. I'm standing atop a desert mountain. I'm starting a brand new job and I'm bleeding profusely. At this moment, there's only one thing I'm thinking with any reasonable degree of certainty, and that one thing is a bit of a problem. I'm about to die. Well, as we say in the game, the great thing about baseball is that every single day, you have a chance to see something you've never seen before. Oh sure, hundreds of people safely hike Camelback Mountain near Phoenix, Arizona, every year. Many of them even make it all the way up, and then all the way down again without even lugging back a patch of souvenir cactus needles sticking out of their skin. Today I'm not one of those people. I am stuck, things are getting dicey, and I already can close my eyes and visualize one of the lead stories on MLB Network television. New San Francisco Giants mental skills coach and former Major League pitcher Bob Tewksbury met his demise today when... And to think, all this started innocently enough with a phone call from San Francisco Giants general manager Bobby Evans 3 months earlier. Over the next several days, we talked, questions were answered, philosophies were discussed, arrangements were made, a contract was signed. Now, here we were in the spring of 2017, and talk about a change in altitude. For the first time since 1999, I was employed by a Major League Baseball club other than the Boston Red Sox. The finality of the big move really hit when I boarded the plane on that mid-February day, headed west to Arizona instead of south to Florida. I was eager for the change in scenery, both literal and metaphorical. Especially because I could see so many similarities between San Francisco and Boston, the place where I had become so comfortable over the past two decades. There we won the World Series title in 2004, 2007, and 2013, with a great core group of homegrown players like Dustin Pedroia, Jacoby Ellsbury, Kevin Youkilis, Xander Bogaerts, Jon Lester, Jonathan Papelbon, and Clay Buchholz. Here, they won three World Series in 5 years with a great core group of homegrown players like Buster Posey, Madison Bumgarner, Matt Cain, Brandon Crawford, Brandon Belt, and Joe Panic. Leading this band of brothers was Bruce Bochy, surely a Hall of Fame manager one day, and a skipper I knew well after pitching for him in San Diego in 1996. It took a few days to get settled into a new routine and the strange sensation of wearing the orange and black of the Giants instead of the red and blue of the Red Sox was the least of it. But each day got better, and daily, driving to my apartment in Scottsdale, I had a clear view of Camelback Mountain to the west. It was the most prominent landmark in the area, 2,707 feet in altitude and about 5 miles from the Giants' minor league complex. Appropriately named due to the profile that resembles the hump and the head of a kneeling camel. Admiring that beautiful sight daily, I was intrigued enough to ask Dave Greschner, the Giants' longtime head trainer, about the mountain. He gave me the lowdown, popular hiking spot, on occasionally both major and minor league players run the mountain for conditioning. Is it difficult, I asked? Not so much, Gresh told me. It's okay as long as you stay on the trail. But every year, a lot of people wind up getting airlifted off the mountain because of dehydration or injury. If you go up there, Tewks, make sure you stay on the path, Gresh reiterated. Now, I'm not really a hiker, although I do like to walk. Maybe the former is evident of the fact that I laced up my new Nike turf shoes that day after our short, early spring workout, pulled on my Giants spring training issued shorts and conditioning t-shirt, failed to tell anyone I was going on a hike, and proceeded to take on a mountain, alone, that I knew nothing about. It couldn't be that difficult, could it? People of all ages hike Camelback. I parked, grabbed my phone, and in the unlikely event I would need it, snagged a bottle of water and breathed into the arid desert air. There are two different entry points to Camelback Mountain, Chola and Echo. The easier hike, I was told, was the Chola Trail. So off I went. En route, I stopped to read the information posted on the big sign at the trailhead. No pets, check. Bring water, check. Get off the mountain before dark, check. It was only 3 p.m. And stay on the path. Got it. Maybe here is where I should mention, I don't like heights. Flying I've become accustomed to, but even driving on tall bridges gives me the shakes. Put me in a glass elevator standing next to the back panel and I stop breathing and must look the other way. Nevertheless, stay on the trail and all will be good. It wasn't long before I got some elevation which provided some fabulous views of the valley, my new spring home. As I hiked higher, I got a little anxious but simply kept my head down and kept going, looking up just to take in the view here and there. The sights were amazing. The trail wasn't crowded, and a couple ahead of me finally stopped to turn back and head down the mountain. Was this the summit? Nah, can't be, can it? I decided to keep going until I came to a point in the trail that left me unsure of which way to go. Nobody was around to ask or follow. As I scanned the area, it looked like the path was straight ahead. I think now that perhaps that's another rule of hiking. If you're unsure whether you should be going in a particular direction, you probably shouldn't. So I hiked. The path narrowed. I hiked. The path narrowed even more. I hiked. Whoa. About 1,800 feet up in the air, looking out over Greater Phoenix, is utterly spectacular. The entire valley sprawls out below me. The iconic Phoenician golf course and resort is directly at the base of the mountain. In the distance, I can see Tempe and Arizona State University. To my right, I see the big dome football stadium in Glendale, home of multiple Super Bowls, and other parts west. And about 60 or 70 feet above me, to my right, is what I think is the top of the mountain. Man, I'm this close. I think I should hike a little bit farther. In my head, I began to hear a friendly and familiar voice. My dear friend, Dan Luker, who we all know as Adventure Dan. He was a hockey player at Hamilton College in Clinton, New York, and a huge Boston Bruins fan, and today continues to play hockey into his 60s. He's one of those guys you probably have in your own group of friends, too. The one that's always up to take the risk. Swim with the sharks? Yeah, why not? It'll be fun. Kayak around the jetty at Wells Beach back home in Maine in the middle of a blinding rainstorm with high winds? It'll be fun. This voice filling my ears, I put my head down and climbed a bit farther. Yep. As I tell the players I coach, it's amazing how far you can travel when you have a goal and focus on the next step. Adventure Dan wouldn't stop now, and despite the slope of the terrain, a few more rocks and cacti, and heck, maybe even a snake or two, I wouldn't either. I was almost there. Finally, far enough, I figured I'd better turn around. I didn't want to be like those losers my new head trainer was telling me about who had to be helicoptered off the mountain. So I turned around. Surely this was the path back? Wait. Where's the path? Somehow, back who knows how many steps, I had edged off it. Well, I know I have to go east, which is staying to my left, and knowing this, I am quite sure I will merge back onto the path I somehow exited at any moment now. As I hike, though, I do not see any path. As my heart begins to race, I pause for a moment of rational thought. Okay, I tell myself, retrace your steps, go back to where you were, take another look for the path. So I start to do that. Wham! There was an excruciating...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.